The only spiritual life you need is not to react. That is calmness, the great heritage of the world, the greatest power you can have. If you can learn to be calm, you will solve all problems. This is something you should always remember. When you perfectly calm, there is no time for anything. Karma, illusion, everything become null and void. The mind is like water. When it's turbulent, it's different to see. When it's calm, everything become clear. If you repair calm and unassumed about situation, outcome, including what happened tomorrow, then everything is fine. There is no need to worry. The most important aspect of spiritual life is to avoid reaction, attempting to change others. Instead, practice not react anything at all. Live in the present moment and avoid dwelling on the past, worrying. Embrace the internal now, where all is well. Don't travel the world, avoid reacting to your body or thought, practicing being a witness, quietness, stillness in your mind. Learn to understand your thoughts, emotions without reacting to them. A serene, tranquil mind like a still lake can reflect the beauty of its surrounding, while the blue lake cannot reflect anything. Quiet your mind. When your mind is still, you can observe without becoming attached. Observe your thoughts, allow them to pass without trying to change anything. Don't follow your thoughts pattern. Just let them come and go. Do not buy into your thoughts. Do not fight against your feelings. Simply observe them. Do not relax to nothing. Do not hold on your anger. Do not react to your doubt. Whatever you react to, product of the mind. It's only the mind that gets angry. Mind becomes stubborn. It's the mind that wants to regret. It is the mind get hurt. But if you master your mind, where is anger? Where is the depression? Where are reaction situation? They will not exist. The enlightened state is only internal peace. Peace is essence of consciousness. Consciousness is always peaceful, always happy, has nothing to do with the condition. All conditioning coming from the mind. Do not try to alter condition. Do not change situation. Every time you use mind to try to change something, you are inflating your ego. They will give you even more problems. Simply learn to control the mind, making it passive and silent. You find, recognize yourself as nothing. Do not see yourself anything. And always keep in mind, absolutely nothing needed to be done. And this is how to become happy. It's full, joyful, when there are nothing in mind, happening, become productive. And then doubt comes when anger comes to you, when fear comes to you, now entertain them. Quickly shift the focus of your mind, and whatever it takes, read your situation allies. Do not entertain fear, doubt, and anger, and do not allow your thoughts to become bigger than you. And no matter what your thoughts say, do not feed them. Remember that your thoughts are not your friend. Your thoughts try to confuse and mislead you. They will tell you all kind of things. Do not listen to your thought, even your good thought, which transcends everything. What matters for you is praise, your joy, and your happiness, and your thought. You don't need to reserve time for meditation. You can do it while driving your car, while at work, while listening to music. It's just being aware of yourself. Where you really are, I realize that the rest is projection of your mind. This universe, my friend, is optical illusion. You look at the movie and see all kind of chaos happening. Then you catch yourself It's just a movie, isn't it? And so is it with life. If you observe everything that's happening in life, you observe, you look, see. However, never react if you never fall against. If you understand this, you become free. If you are what you are seeking, the answer is always within you alone. And there is nothing in the external world, for external world emanation of your own mind, your own thought, your own imagination. If you create this world, the only way to awake this through silence, not through analysis, affecting, separating what's good and bad, but rather through simple silent abandoning those content or one or dogma and concept, abandoning this thing daily. The great truth is exclude or not dwell, so empty yourself totally, complete all your ideas, your feelings, everything must be empty, and you become totally and completely empty, there is nothing you do to feel it again. And realization is emptiness, it is the self, it is your true nature, and no matter how many times I tell you, you are simply thinking, judging, coming to conclusion, try to solve your life. Let go completely, absolutely, completely. If you must let go completely, then you will not feel any body, no mind, no actor, nothing. That's what I mean. And you become totally and completely empty, there is nothing you need to feel it again. And realization is emptiness, it is the self, it is your true nature. And no matter how many times I tell you, you are futile thinking, judging, coming to conclusion, try to solve your life. Let go completely, absolutely, completely. If you must let go so completely, then you feel not feel anybody, no mind, no actor, nothing. That's what I'm saying. You are not going to turn into vegetable. You just sit like a log. And if you listen to me correctly, everything you're doing right, you feel happier than ever you've been in your life. It's because you realize none of this matter. You're not no one really doing anything. I'll make you to go if pain completely eliminate. If you are perfect, neutral self, nothing else exists, nothing else ever exists, nothing else will exist there. It's only one high, and that is you. And rejoice, it's only one. This I is consciousness. When you follow the personal to I source, that becomes the universal I, which is consciousness. And rejoice, it's only one, this I is consciousness. When you follow the personal I to the source, it becomes the universal I, which is consciousness. And you begin to control yourself, begin to realize your divine nature. And you do this, being quiet is the quickest way to realize to be quiet. Don't abandon thoughts, abandon the mind, abandon everything. The optimal response is have no response at all. When a thought, feeling, or reaction, follows shortly after. This is such a routine, that might not even be aware of every single through the emotional trigger reaction.
As a result,
you are entirely at the mercy of your thought and emotion, operating on autopilot and no control. When you focus on the so-called future, your attention. As a result, you are entirely at the mercy of your thought and emotion, operating on autopilot with no control. When you focus on the so-called future, your attention consumed by as your attention distract energy more and more thought arise, resulting in a thought faking solution, pure delusion, and those who rebel the delusion themselves arrive mind force reality. This mind attack causes significant pain. There is simple approach to transcend it all. Transforward may be difficult or uncomfortable practice.
It is necessary to trust in your being and relinquish all efforts.
Understanding the nature of awareness is crucial because it can lead to a quick result. Being aware is a powerful force, important because awareness is healing energy that imbues with pure love. By constraints arise your being, not reaction, anything you allow your body, mind to begin healing themselves. Each vital obeys you through the emotion without identifying with them, reacting to them. This allows emotion to flow, release the direct healing energy towards them. Don't be discouraged. It seems difficult in the beginning. Just keep practice the experience of not reacting. Remember, this is not a mental activity. It's about releasing effort, trust in your being. This process may seem scary for your ego.